Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Look at all like this because I just got out of the shower and I'm going to be filming a look with my So Jaded palette from ColourPop. I got this in actually a little while ago and I've been using it for a bit, so this is definitely not like a first impression or anything, but I'm loving this palette and this is like such a perfect like fall, winter, holiday. Like this is a very good palette for this like time of year and this season, I feel like. So I wanted to film a quick little look with it. I haven't really done a ton of makeup videos lately. I've been doing a lot of like home and lifestyle and vlogs and fashion videos. So I wanted to mix it back up a little bit and do a eyeshadow look real quick. As you can tell, I did the rest of my face already. So we're just gonna be doing the eyes today, just because if I did my whole face, we would be here for a while. So I hope that you guys enjoy. I will get myself together by the end of this video, but my hair is just like still soaking wet and I'm really warm and cozy in my bathroom, so I wanted to stay like this. So I hope that you guys enjoy, and if you would like to see a look with this palette, then just keep watching. So we're starting like I literally always do with just a matte bone like creamy shade just to set the lid. I like have to do this. And then with You're a Gem, which is a, like kind of this lighter peachy tone. It like looks a little bit more orange on the camera, but it's like this really nice light pale like clementine kind of color. And just like with a huge fluffy brush, I edited so much of this out, but I just like blended and blew this out literally everywhere, all over the crease, above, below. I just put this everywhere just to have it as like a transitional color so that I could use this shade Jasper, which is like, as you can tell, a little bit cooler toned. Like it's still kind of warm toned, but a little less orangey peachy than that first one. And I use a little bit more of like a slightly more concentrated brush, and I just blew that out like throughout the crease also, not quite as high or as low as the first shade, but I still put that all throughout the crease just so it kind of transitioned into that first orange shade and kind of made a little like gradient between those two colors. And again, I was like building this up a lot, like mostly in the outer part of the crease and then like slowly blending it in, but I definitely concentrated most of the color on the outside. I did tightline then, but I know a lot of people don't like to see that, so I didn't really include a lot of clips of that, but I tightlined a little bit. I like to do that before I do too much of my eyeshadow because I have to like touch my eyelid, so I didn't want to mess anything up, so I just quickly tightlined and then just use some glitter glue, which I do literally every single time I use a shimmer shade, even if it's not like a true glitter, just to like really help it stick and pop. So I'm using this really nice light, like it's just a very perfect lid shade for kind of like just a pop of brightness on the lid. And then I wanted to use this like cranberry, like wine berry kind of shade, and I'm kind of doing a halo eye sort of. I just like really wanted to incorporate some fun like fall colors, so that's why I'm using this color. I thought it was such a fun like fall tone, especially with like the browns. So I just put that on the outer corner. Again, I edited a lot of this out because I packed this on the outer corner and on the inner corner like a lot of times just to build up the color. And then of course I left just like that spotlight shade right in the center, and then I just went back to that Jasper shade on like a really concentrated like domed brush just to like really define the crease. This is obviously not a cut crease or anything, but it got a little bit like covered up as I was applying the shimmer shade, so I just like redefined that a little bit and then went back to that original shade, that peachy shade, just per usual to like reapply and reblend and just like really make sure that gradient was really apparent. And then I just love this stone shade. I wanted to like add a little bit more depth to this look, but of course I didn't want to cover up that like cranberry shade that we have on like the outer third of the lid. So outside of that, as you can see, I'm kind of like focusing it like a V, and I'm just defining the outer part of the eye just a little tiny bit to add some more definition without covering anything up. And then I just went back in after I applied that with a brush with no product on it just to like blend it and make everything a little bit more seamless. And then with this like super orangey shade, like we haven't used this color yet, but I did again want to make this like very fall and like, you know, kind of holiday-esque. So I wanted to incorporate some more warm tones, and I just drug that all over the bottom lash line. My tight line eyeliner kind of like obviously bled down, so you're getting a little bit of the black kind of blended in with that. And then per usual, I'm just highlighting my brow bones and my inner corners with the same shade. It's not the same shade as my lid, it's like a slightly lighter shade, a little bit more of like a golden shade. And I always have my brow bone and my inner corner matching.
Hello guys, I am back. I like got myself together, and by got myself together, I mean I brushed my hair
and put on a t-shirt and some jewelry. So this is the completed look. I just put mascara on. I didn't put any liner or anything just because I kind of wanted like the shadow to do its thing. And I feel like this is just a very like fall, even kind of holiday look. I was actually thinking if you were to switch out the orange on the bottom lash line and use this like a really pretty like emerald green. Oh, it's actually called emerald. If you use this color on the bottom lash line, this could be a really pretty like kind of Christmassy holiday look. But then I actually wanted to originally use this color on the lid, this like really crazy glittery color, but I have contacts in today and this is technically like an actual glitter. It's not even a shadow, it's like glitter, like craft glitter. So I didn't want to risk that falling out like into my eyes and messing with my contacts, but I really wanted to use that. I'm going to try that look when on a day I'm wearing my glasses, and I feel like that would also be a really pretty thing to put in the center here, and then it will be like very, very fall appropriate. And so there's just so much you can do with this palette, and I feel like this look is kind of a fun base for a lot of different looks. It's got cool tones, it's got warm tones, it's like glam but a little grungy. I really like how it came out. So let me know what you guys think. Thank you so much for watching. If you would like, subscribe, we would love to have you. We have so much fun here, and until next time, I will see y'all in our next video. Bye guys.